Synesthesia is a rare and incredible condition where people can see sounds or hear colors. But what happens in someone's brain that makes them this kind of superhuman? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into DNews today. I am Trace. Synesthesia is a neurological condition where a person's stimuli get crossed. When a synesthete experiences stimuli along one cognitive pathway, another pathway activates as well, causing an involuntary sensory experience. 5% of humans have some form of synesthesia, and they can come in different types. For example, a violinist right here in the Bay Area, Caitlin Hova, hears music and then sees corresponding colors. But a local painter and artist, Mary Searing, feels that certain letters, numbers, or days of the week have specific color shades. If you want to see a VR experience that we made with Caitlin to experience her synesthesia along with her, we just posted one right here on DNews. It is super cool. Go check that out. To be diagnosed with synesthesia, according to Dr. Veronica Gross of Boston University, the synesthetic reaction has to be, quote, involuntary but elicited, irrepressible, and stable. There are a bunch of different types of synesthesia. The most common are color-graphemic, where letters or numbers seem to have colors or patterns, like Mary, or color-auditory, where sounds produce colors and textures and shapes, like Caitlin. But theoretically, there could be as many types of synesthesia as there are sensory pairings. We could experience, like, taste-hearing pairings, where tasting things might produce a sound, or sound-touch pairings, where touching different things would produce different sounds, or smell-color pairings, where things smell like certain colors, or a handful of other combinations, depending on how many senses you believe we have. There could be dozens of synesthetes out there. On my other show, Test 2 Plus, I did discuss how human senses include thermoreception, pressure, pain, magnetoreception, balance. There's so many, so there could be a lot of synesthetes. Studies across a bunch of journals have attempted to figure out just what's going on in the brains of these people. Researchers conducted fMRI scans of synesthetes while activating their specific synesthetic triggers and found evidence to support the theory that their brains are somehow cross-wired. In one example, color-auditory synesthetes saw their superior frontal gyrus light up, which is connected to self-awareness and the sensory system, as did what is called the color center, which is defined in this study as V4 and V8, and then its neighboring region, the fusiform gyrus. They're not really sure what the fusiform gyrus does, actually, but synesthetes were seeing colors, but the primary visual cortex wasn't active, indicating the color cortex was wired directly to interact with the fusiform gyrus and somehow create this synesthetic experience. Though scientists don't know that much about synesthesia, people who have it say they've experienced this extrasensory crosstalk pretty much for as long as they can remember. Researchers have yet to understand just how people develop it, but they have found two main types: developmental synesthesia or acquired synesthesia. Developmental or inborn synesthesia seems to be genetically passed on through families, and some theorize that synesthesia might be an inherited trait on the X chromosome because it skews so heavily female. But a study in the American Journal of Human Genetics disproved that, finding instead multiple chromosomes are implicated in the transmission of the condition. Acquired synesthesia, on the other hand, can manifest in those who are on hallucinogenic drugs or in people who have had neurological conditions like epileptic seizures, which may have altered their physical brain matter. According to Scientific American, grapheme synesthetes report having good memory for phone numbers, security codes, and polysyllabic anatomical terminology because the colors aid them in recalling this information. A paper in PLOS One from March of 2015 attempted to explain letter color combination synesthesia by looking at the magnetic English alphabet that some people have on their fridge. Of the 6,500 synesthetes they tested, they found at least 6% of the participants saw shades that matched those of the magnetic toy. In fact, those born closer to the date that that toy was released saw even more alignment with the colors, up to 15%. Some scientists think that perhaps children learned to associate colors with words or letters inadvertently to aid their memory through synesthetic adaptation. Of course, this doesn't explain all synesthetes, only a small number, but it shows that people can learn this behavior. Most of the research I found was in English. I'd love to see more in other languages, especially like ideogram-based characters, like in Chinese. In the end, though, synesthesia is not a disorder, and the cause remains unknown. It's an incredible mystery of the human body. Not all auditory visual synesthetes see the same things, and not all grapheme synesthetes connect the same words, letters, or numbers with the same colors. Even people within the same family, two synesthetes will manifest differently. As of now, scientists are scanning and learning as much as they can about the condition to learn about how our brains perceive the world around us and construct our individual realities. I've been wanting to talk about synesthesia for a long time. Maybe you sensed my excitement here on DNews. But today, you may have noticed, we just posted a brand new virtual reality experience. You can watch Caitlin Hova play the violin here in San Francisco and see her synesthesia along with the music. It's super cool. And on the computer, just so you know, you can click and drag the video around to see what Caitlin sees. But it's even better on the phone because the accelerometer will follow your head as you look around the scene. And even better if you use headphones and grab a VR headset or one of those cardboard kits online. Then you can see what it's like to be a synesthete for yourself. Tell us what you think about synesthesia down in the comments. And if you have it, why don't you tell us about it? That's super neat. Thanks for watching, everybody. Please subscribe so you get more DNews, and I'll see you tomorrow.